pray, God, save me from persecution, save me from hatred, protect me from this, protect me from that. Release your leaders. When we murmur against them, we fight against them, chide against them, striving against them, they'll be busy praying for themselves, personal protection and personal happiness and personal joy, personal this. Oh Lord, take care of me. It looks like this and that. Release your leaders to just pray for you. By the way, do you know that in this same chapter, look at verse 8, then came Amalek and fought with Israel in Rephidim. The Amalekites were right at the corner, about to destroy them, about to kill them. And here they were chiding and striving and fighting about water. And then they wanted to even stone Moses because of no water to drink when the Amalekites were there. And it says, and Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men and go out and fight with them, with Amalek. And tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand. Nobody could manifest the power in that rod except Moses. They wanted to stone him. And now here was the Amalekites. If they had killed Moses and stoned Moses because of water to drink, you might get water to drink, and then you get rid of the man, and then the Amalekites came. What are you going to do? It was Moses that solved the problem. And then he says, so Joshua did as Moses had said unto him, and fought with Amalek. And Moses and Aaron and all went to the top of the hill. And it came to pass, when Moses held up his hand, that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. Anytime that Moses was tired, enemies prevailed. Anytime his hands were down, enemies prevailed. Anytime he was so discouraged and depressed, unhappy, and he couldn't, you know, keep up his Sunday anymore because he has so much pressure upon his life, enemies prevailed. That's why we're told that in verse 12, but Moses' hands were heavy, and he took his stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon, and Aaron and all stayed up his hands, the one on the one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. What's the result? I said, what's the result? And Joshua discomfited Amalek, and his people were the edge of the sword. I wish I were there in the land of Israel, and I tell those people, be reasonable, be wise, stop all the murmuring. Let Moses have some fresh air to breathe so that he'll be able to minister the best unto you. Let's look at Numbers chapter 14, highlighting the deadly disease of murmuring. That thing killed them, destroyed them. Their murmuring injured them, hurt them. And the murmuring was about non-essentials. Have you ever thought about that? Non-essentials. Food. Water to drink. The mundane things of this life. And they forgot the very essential, important things of life. Murmuring. We're looking at Numbers chapter 14, verse 21. But as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord, because all those men which have seen my glory and my miracles, which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness, and have tempted me now these 10 times, and I'm not hearkening to my voice, surely they shall not see the land which I swear unto their fathers, neither shall any of them that provoke me see it. Their murmuring cut them off from the land of Canaan. These people were not thinking of the future. Moses had told them the land we're going is a land filled with a lot of things, a land flowing with milk and honey. Whatever you miss here today, you're going to get it in the land we're going, because all the fruits of the land, all the houses of the people, all the fertile ground, everything belongs to you. Just be patient a little, and not more because of the heat of the day today, because of the future. Think of the future. Think of yourself. And think of the great reward that is coming unto you. And when you think of that, then the present day needs or pressures or problems are not going to be so important. You look at verse 26. In verse 26, and the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation which murmur against me? Have you noticed something here? At this time now, they need to worship idol, but God just overlooked that. At this time, they didn't make any idol to themselves. God just overlooked that. At this time, they didn't call the name of the Lord in vain. God overlooked that. At this time, they were not breaking the Sabbath day law. God overlooked that. At this time, they were honoring their father and honoring their mother. God overlooked that. At this time, they were not stealing. They were not committing adultery. They were not being covetous. All the commandments, everything was in place. There was no complaint about that. Only this murmuring. You know what murmuring does? Every other good quality in your life becomes overlooked. Every other good thing you do. You're living a righteous life. You're living a holy life. And then you are, you know, giving to the poor. You are very generous. You are merciful. You are compassionate. Every other thing is in place in your life. When murmuring comes in, every other good thing is overlooked. You lose the benefit of the good things you have done, of the good things you are doing, when the murmuring comes in. And the Lord said, how long shall I bear with this evil congregation which murmur against me? I have heard their murmurings, the murmurings of the children of Israel, which they murmur against me. Say unto them, as truly as I live, says the Lord, as ye have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you. Your carcasses shall fall in this wilderness. They will die. That's why we call the murmuring a life-threatening disease. It killed them. It destroyed them. Look at verse 36. In verse 36, it says, and the men which Moses sent to search the land, who returned and made all the congregation to murmur against him. They made the congregation to murmur by what they said, by the evil report they gave. The Lord hated murmuring so much that even the people that instigated that murmuring by bringing up his slander upon the land, even those men in verse 37 that did bring up the evil report upon the land, died by the plague before the Lord. You see that? Cut short their lives. Murmuring, a life-threatening disease. It's not something we gamble with, something we play with. So when we murmur, we instigate other people, influence other people to murmur. Cut short our lives. All the other good qualities we have and the good things we have done, everything is forgotten because we murmur and because we allow other people to murmur. Like spoiled children, those Israelites, spoiled children, they murmured against God and against Moses, but they only groaned under the taskmasters of Egypt. Have you thought about that? What are they seeing here? More than what they saw in Egypt. In Egypt, the oppression was much. The lashes on their back. The denial forced on them. The slavery that they forced on them in Egypt. They didn't murmur. They didn't murmur against Pharaoh. They didn't murmur against those taskmasters. All they did was to cry, not murmur. All they did was to groan, oh Lord, look at our condition. They didn't murmur. When you think about the church, and where maybe you're teaching in school, and your principal, your headmaster, is kind of ferocious, furious, and a tyrant. You don't murmur.
That you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation. Those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing, and by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray. You are my God.
say, oh, 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 Lord.